Go ahead.
Hey guys, I'm Jared from SAPT. I just wanted to go over a technique that we use at SAPT now for our manual therapy service. Today I'm going to be going over some spindle cell compression and kind of how we're going to be using it to help people move and feel better. So Kelsey has a lack of shoulder flexion on her right side, as you can see. She has kind of a deficit here. We also know that through injury history and some other things that she's also had some trauma to her left hip, both hips really, but for this case we're going to be focusing more on her left hip. Upon recently, she's been having a lot of gunkiness in her adductor magnus, and we know that that left hip should help to stabilize that right shoulder, and that via the anatomy trains by Thomas Myers, that that deep core line, if there's some gunk going on in the adductors, it is going to severely affect her thoracic extension. So that's also going to play a role into what she can do. Okay, so for today, I'm actually going to go over a technique that not a lot of people use, especially in manual therapy anymore. It's called spindle cell compression. This is actually a very light technique, so not like deep tissue where it's going to dig in and it's going to really hurt. Spindle cell compression actually works by manipulating her sensory information. So a muscle spindle cell is a mechanoreceptor in a muscle that will send sensory information to the spine on the length of that muscle. Sometimes through trauma or compensations, these spindle cells will become dysfunctional, and they will upregulate the signal that they're sending to the spinal cord. When that signal is upregulated, the motor information from the efferent fibers will also be upregulated to those fibers. So it's getting more of a sense, and then automatically the nervous system is going to send more of that motor input and cause this muscle to tighten up, become a little bit more tonic. So if I palpate around, you can see that she has some gunky bits. And then if I can find, usually the spindle cells will be very sensitive and they'll be palpable. And so all you do is just you apply a little bit of compression, and we're going to make the spindle cells a little bit shorter. And so this is going to actually down-regulate a lot of the sensory information that her nervous system is getting. And so by down-regulating the sensory information, it's also going to down-regulate the efferent information. So she's going to be getting less motor input. The muscles should start to be less tense. It should actually start to relax a little bit. And after doing this, you know, it can be from 30 seconds to 2 minutes. It will temporarily inhibit that motor stimulation it was getting, and then the fibers will cool down. And as I was saying, just through the fascial trains, that we know if we can cause less tension here, in her deep core line, there should be less tension all the way up, so she should be able to get a little bit more thoracic extension. And hopefully her hip will become a little bit more stable, just because if we have something that's upregulated here through reciprocal inhibition, it's going to throw off some stuff in her glutes and external rotators. Okay, and so now if we retest, so she got a few more inches, not quite to the wall yet, which means there's still some work that we need to do, but she obviously got, I don't know, maybe 3 or 4 more inches. Next, we would just be working on a couple other things and see how we could get that to stick.